Welcome to Bookworm. This is our heritage building, built in 1905, and first Marathi boys school of Puchukis, Goa. Bookworm runs these four programs. First is library and the resource center, wherein we have more than 25,000 books. Bookworm conducts many activities for children. Our goal is to spread the love of reading to all. We have libraries in school programs, wherein one of our team goes in schools to conduct library sessions on a weekly basis. Another is mobile outreach program. This is a community-based program wherein our team goes in the communities to conduct library sessions for the children who do not have access to books. And the last is our professional development program, wherein we conduct many workshops for the teachers, librarians and the educators. And we also conduct the 7 months library educators course certificate. We also have a new arrival shelf and the graphic books.
This is our reception counter. We have some Bookworm library plans, borrowing plans over here. And these are the library membership cards. And we have almost around 1,500 memberships. And these are the card made by the children, handmade cards these are. This is our book, some published by Bookworm.
This is our Goa shelf, divided into different categories like fiction, non-fiction, biography and historical. Here is a small Goan display representing Goan sweets. Please have some of them.
Good morning and welcome to Bookworm Library. Along this corridor is our section for adult books. We have fiction books, we have non-fiction books, biographies, autobiographies, thrillers, and so many more books. We can now move to the room which houses our books for young adults. This room has books for young adults. We have classics, must-reads, fantasies, books for pre-teens. And now, let's see what's going to happen in this room.
Hello, my name is Charlotte. What's yours? This is a book about me. You can find me in the must-reads.
Aye, aye, matey, I'm looking for my book. Pirate school! I'm going to the pirate school! Come with me!
Hi! I'm Giovanni and I can juggle and I'm from this book!
This passage, we have books in different languages, Konkani, Marathi, Kannada, Telugu, and on this shelf, we have all our poetry books for different age groups.
That was really wonderful. I mean, although right now we can't go to this library, but I felt so interested in looking at all the books. And I'm sure if any other kid will also watch this, they will be very much interested in going to library.
Thank you, Ruchi. We actually had to put some things like this together in the lockdown to remind our children about the library. So I'm so glad we can share a bit with you all. So since we can't be in the library, it seemed important to set the context. So today what we're going to do, we all know we go into libraries to borrow books, to read quietly, to reference, to research. But over the last few years, we've been ideating a lot with how we bring the library to children, particularly children who are non-readers or children who are struggling with reading. And we've actually been using a whole practice of games in the library for multiple reasons. And today I've just chosen a set of games that really will focus more on language and parts of speech, just as a kind of teaser for teachers here to get a sense of what is possible if you just have a shelf of books. And maybe we are done reading the books and discussing the books, but just if you want to play games with books. So as I shared over the years, for us, communities with are very diverse. And so we have to find ways to bring non-readers to reading, because we accept and have internalized that once you become an independent reader, then the pathway to learning is actually fully open and wide open to you. So acquiring this competency and fluency of reading is so critical for our children, particularly diverse children who don't necessarily come from literate backgrounds. The other wonderful experience we've had is when we work with groups of teachers and they come into the library and they play games, it's like rediscovering a childhood, but also becoming open to the idea that learning doesn't have to be hard, that learning can also happen with some lightness and with some fun. So we have these two strong objectives today in what we're going to try and demonstrate. We're hoping to play three games with you. And the first game we will play is called Shelf Help. And in Shelf Help, it's a library shelf that is going to help you navigate this game. So the rules are really simple. Just let me pull up my screen. Please give me a minute. I'm not very proficient in all of this. I hope you can see this. Ruchi, is this visible?
Yes, it is. It is. We can see that.
Okay, great. So the round one in Shelf Help is called I Spy. Many of us would have played it as young children. You've got to spot something and you've got to call it out. The rule for I Spy is basically this. I thought we could quickly play with teams, but looking at the numbers, it's the logistics are frightening. I'm going to give up on this team idea now.
But maybe we can just ask people to unmute and speak a little bit.
Yes.
If you want. Huh?
Yes. But typically what would happen in a classroom, I'm just going to quickly give you this. It's a really broad idea. You just use the rows. If the children sit in rows, if they sit in groups, you just use groups. But there is some joy in playing as a team as long as you don't make it competitive and aggressive. So that power rests with you, the facilitator. But for games, I've realized that there is some fun in having some metric so that even the learner knows where they are moving. But since you're adults, I want you to just imagine teams. You can type chat or call out your responses. The jury will be Lalita and Ruchi, who are going to say right or wrong. Your very simple instructions. You look at a bookshelf. You listen to what I'm saying. And then whatever Ruchi and Lalita say is the correct answer is the correct answer. So people ready, here's our shelf. We've got a stash of books on this shelf. Your first task is who can quickly call out a word that includes the letter A.
Baby tree.
Hated.
Okay, baby, not tree. Baby is right. Hated.
Pile is lost.
Pile. Yeah. The word.
Head. Only pile. Yeah.
Head.
A sick day.
Oh.
Yes. A sick day.
Either a or sick day. I'm not taking.
Hail, ma'am. Samir.
Hated.
Mailman. William.
You can all type on chat also if you
want. Kyle. Footpath.
Yes.
Excellent.
Footpath. Yeah.
What's very clear is we've got a whole bunch of readers in this room. Wonderful.
Animal. About animal.
You've got 100 points. Teacher, you've got 100 points. Thank you. That was your warm-up round. Okay. The next one. Now I'm only going to take the first you're like 180 people, the first five responses. Find, now listen to the instruction, okay? Find or call out a word that has the letter G.
Girl.
The girl who hated books.
Girl.
Goes, excellent.
Maggie.
Goes.
Gabriel
Grimald.
Wonderful. We are beginning to look at the creators of books. The illustrator Gabriel Grimald has three wonderful spotting. Good eyes. I'm sure that's a really young teacher. Fantastic. So we're going to move to the next quick round, which is a word with W.
Written.
Again, I'm sure that's a young teacher. Wonderful. We are doing splendidly. Now I want a word that has a double vowel. A double vowel. You know your
double vowel.
Head.
Okay, I'm going to stop you, teachers. I'm looking for double vowels that sit together. So, stolen has O and E, but they're not the same vowel, no? Camouflage is right in one way. House
Samir.
Colon is right because they have two vowels.
Three.
But not the second vowel. Excellent. You are a wonderful group of participants.
Biblio Burro. Biblio is there, ma'am.
Ah, Biblio. Now, because we have been chattering so much, I want you to
just mute
everybody. And now I want you to pick a pen or a pencil and a bit of paper. And I want you to look carefully at the titles. Now listen to this. And find me words that are within the word. I'll give you one example. If I take the title of Samir's house, for me the word use, U-S-E, is sitting in the word house, and I can write it down because U-S-E is a word that exists in house. I want you to look, you could easily find 10.
And people are posting on chat. Can you see, Sujata?
Oh no, as a
Okay, I'll read it out for you. There is...
Wait. Let's give everybody time, okay?
Okay.
I'll just set a timer because always the ones who are fast...
Takia the mailman. So man is...
Sir, this is not a talking exercise, a writing exercise. Right?
You have to type on chat.
I'm giving you 2 minutes. We'll just be quiet. Maybe I'll give you 1 minute. So we got 30 seconds more.
Yeah, because already we have got 20 responses. Yeah, they're coming so fast, I can't even keep track of
it. Reads?
Yeah.
Okay, let's start hearing, Ruchi.
Okay. So Yeah, male in mailman, yes. Foot yes. In footpath, footpath flowers, foot and path, male, sandwiches. I don't know what.
Sandwiches?
Yeah,
no,
I don't know.
Sandwiches.
No. Yeah, then Lent and silent. Then rate, low and lower, I think from flower. Pay, rated, due.
Rated is coming from where? There's no rated.
I don't think so. There is a rate. There is no. And the vowels are not together. Yeah. So then hated again, I don't know. Wahao.
It is a
man word, also.
But we can't. It's already there.
Yeah.
It
is there. Us in music. Then am in Samir. He lower every day. I don't know what. How did they get
Please,
every day?
Every day won't come. No, there's no.
Yeah,
way.
Yeah. And then use man. Then stole in stolen.
Yes.
Deer, he.
Deer is come from where though? There's no.
I way. Have no idea. I think the person thought that they have to make
can take
such
any
a word.
Letters, huh? Okay.
Yeah.
So if that was the game, yes. But in this instruction, no. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then stone, flow, ill from William, he in head, then rated in illustrated, but still the vowels are not together. That's the problem.
No, rated can get, R-A-T-E-D, na? The word illustrated, rated is there in illustrated. Yeah.
But then the vowel, what about the vowel?
Earlier game. So here we don't need the okay.
Okay. Then vision in television. Then or in story. Then am in Amos. Then bib. Will in William. To in story. Biblio in bibliobureau. Camouflage in from camouflage people. Someone has made flag, mug, lag, game, flame. I think that person thought that we have to make words from that.
Flag is right. Flag you get.
Flag will come, but mug, lag, game, you cannot, it's not valid.
Okay.
Yeah.
Quite then, fun. Are there more?
There are quite, but I think it's enough.
Yes, I think we've understood that you have titles and you can start looking for the names. And thank you for everybody for being so positively silent. When we play games in the classroom, we've also realized that it's really important to keep the flow of energy balanced. Often a game can just lead to more and more energy, and that sometimes leads to chaos. The facilitator gets exhausted. The children who can't cope with high stimulation in the class shut down. Children who get overstimulated go off into another end. So it's really important when playing games in the classroom, for library or any subject, to look at your balance. So I wanted to demonstrate how from a highly active game of all of you shouting responses quickly, we could have a game that just brings us down to quiet individual work. And children do this with no trouble at all.
I would agree with you, Sujata, on this, because even when I was teaching, I mean, this used to be an issue because some students, they just shout out the answer and they're always first. And then there are certain shy kids or certain kids who know the answer, who think very creatively, but they never open up and we never get to get a chance to hear them.
Yeah.
So I think it's a wonderful idea.
Yeah, thank you, Ruchi. We move to another slightly noisy game, which you can call out. It's not noisy, but you can call out. It's called the riddle title or just the riddle game. It's again about language. I'm going to ask you now to name the entire title of the book, but I'm going to give you just one clue. So we'll start with a very simple example. I want a title which has the opposite of the word love.
Hate.
The girl who hated books.
Excellent. That person gets
the girl who hated books.
Yeah, the title is The Girl Who Hated Books. So what I'm doing now is I'm also moving you from a word level to a sentence level, to a title level of reading aloud. Yeah. So you're ready, teachers? Next one. A title which has the opposite of the word found.
Pile is lost.
Good job. Now I want a book which has in the title the synonym, which means it's the same meaning, synonym for the word ill. Ill.
A sick day.
Sick day.
A sick day.
Sick. Teacher, I'm a library person. I want to hear the book. A sick day.
Therefore, Amos Begbie.
Thank you. What happens in the library class is when children call out the books like this, the books also become familiar. I'm a tricky library teacher. I want the synonym for, type me with the synonym for rob. This is very easy.
Stolen words.
Now I'm adding a complexity. Only somebody whose name begins with the letter P.
Pile.
No, in the audience can answer. Okay.
Pile is lost.
Now wait, teacher, listen. The person whose name starts with P can answer this question. Find me a book which has in the title the opposite of the word loud.
Silent music.
Excellent. I hope your name began with P.
Yes,
sir. Somebody's name begins with S. Sir, I want you to find me a title which has a proper noun. A proper noun.
File is lost.
Okay. Someone's name begins with P. Find me a
Jew story.
That will also be right. Next William's one.
William's doll.
Faster. Oh, William's doll is on.
Yes.
I'm moving faster, teachers. Find me a name, a title that has a question tag. Anyone can answer. A question tag.
Can you find me?
Yes.
Can you find me a title that has an apostrophe?
Jew story.
There are more.
William's doll.
And there's one more.
Samir's house.
William's doll.
Yes. Jew's story.
Samir's house.
Good. Find me a book which has an exclamation mark.
Case goes to school.
Achha, that first is. Sorry. Chusky goes to school. Correct. Sorry, I've just done some nonsense, and now I have to retrieve my. And I got so excited.
I think it's the annotation, and it's okay. I
think it'll come back. Just give me a second. Just take you back. Yes, it was Chusky goes to school, but it was hidden by.
You have to go to annotation and erase, I think. That it is okay. I think we can see. We'll ignore it if you find it difficult.
Find me a book which has a body part.
Head curry.
Footpath flowers.
Yes. So good. And another one is find me a title that has a synonym for the word book.
Biblio bureau.
Thank you, teacher. Biblio.
Ma'am, it is Biblio bureau.
Yes.
Biblio
in Spanish means books. So good to play these very quick games with you. Now my colleague Lalita had some game that she would like to play with you. I don't know how we're going to play it with so many people. It's really going to make a story, and I'm going to stop sharing. So Lalita, can you hear that?
Yes. Good afternoon. I'll just share my screen.
Deepa, can we make her the co-host?
Yeah.
I'll do that. Hi. So this is a game. It's called Build a Story. Basically, what I would do is, so this is the first image that we have on screen, and it will start with a story. So if you could start with a story that there was a house with an open door. And then I will shuffle. It's like a whole pack of cards. I will shuffle it. And then the it would come to a particular card. And the next person builds on what I have said. So if someone would like to start looking at the first image, and then I will shuffle the cards. And as soon as it stops to the second card, someone takes over from there and adds to the story. So would someone like to start the story?
Yes, ma'am.
Great. Yeah, if you could start, please.
Ma'am, can I?
Sure, go ahead.
Early morning when I opened the door.
Okay.
After that, you can continue.
So the story starts with early morning when I opened the door.
Lovely.
Ma'am, may I?
Let the card stop and then you continue.
Yes, you can continue now.
This is your picture.
I saw, ma'am, may I?
I saw
two elves were standing there.
So early morning when I opened the door, yeah. I saw two elves standing
there.
Okay, Lanta, let's shuffle. Somebody?
Yes, ma'am, may I?
Please go ahead.
Yeah, early morning when I opened the door, I saw two elves were standing there. Nearby, I saw a big kite.
Okay.
Lovely.
Somebody? We opened the door, we saw two elves, we saw a big kite, and then what happens?
Somehow I came across the big friendly giant from the Roald Dahl book that I'd read recently. I really got scared.
So there is a giant as well. Okay. Who are you? Could you be a king or a queen? Can we take the story inwards? I opened the door, there were all these things, including a giant. Now what do we want to say? Come teachers, in a story we have characters, we have setting, we have plot. Can somebody move this story along?
Suddenly all stopped and I saw that watch which was flying and I want that watch. I had wished in my dream, but now I can see it and I'm going to get it now.
Okay,
great. Thank you.
Now what?
The flying watch suddenly fell into the water and a big fish caught it.
Ah, thank you for giving us a problem. Excellent. What's happened to that giant and bird and elves? We don't know.
Where was he?
Maybe somebody can try to make the connection.
I think the giant, the bird and the elves had all come in search of the watch. Okay. But the watch came a little late and it got swallowed by the fish. Okay. So now everybody is waiting to retrieve the watch from the fish.
But now look at the card we've got.
And the one who gets the watch gets to sit on the throne.
I can see that you're concluding this story. Lalita, do we have more turns or it's done?
Yes, we do. Yes, at least four more turns, Sujata, till we end the story.
Okay. So now we know the prize for the watch is to sit on the throne. Now what happens? Who's joining the chase?
But I have to choose between my family.
Now I decided to call all my friends.
So we have two plots, right? Which game do you want to go down? Somebody is saying I have to choose between my family. Calling their friends.
Okay, so the person who gets the watch gets to sit on the throne. So it was morning. So as the sun was rising, the giant stood in front of the sun and the elves looked at the shadow and decided the time was 10:10, just right for sitting on the throne. So the elf got the chance to sit on the throne.
So Lalita, are you spinning or is it over?
Okay. Story. Would someone like to end the story with this card? Anyone can?
Yes.
This is the last card. Can somebody?
Yes, Shilpa.
Last.
Ma'am. And when he sit on the chair, he failed to be in eternity. All his happiness was at the stake, and he just was in relief and painless. You can see the whiteness, peace. He was in peace. Because all things have fallen down where he wanted to. He wanted that throne, and he was just having that time paused on it. So he was very happy, feeling at peace now.
Okay, rather seriously philosophical kind of ending to a slightly crazy story, but this is the magic of stories, isn't it? They can go anywhere. So teachers, I'd just like us to reflect for maybe 30 seconds, and you can post in the chat, what kind of a value would a very quick game like this in the classroom or in the library have for children? What do you think could be some of the outcomes or the purposes of this kind of a game? I mean, you know all the answers, so I'm not wasting my time. I'm going to listen to you. So tell me, sentence formation, everyone gets involved. Yes, Apurva, igniting minds, creativity, listening. Yes, Sunita, listening. Opportunity to speak, excellent. Kids, this is too fast. I have to slow it down.
Imagination, confidence building, developing creativity, communication skills, no right or wrong, rekindle curiosity, quick thinking, grasping power, reflection, observing pictures, logical thinking, collaboration, sit and think, critical thinking, making connections, vocabulary, bridging things, memory development, listening skills, sense improving, creativity and imagination, teamwork, break complexes, it went away. Problem solving, wacky humor.
Nice, Nakki.
Yeah. Experience shared, learning to organize thought, new ideology, critical thinking makes them curious, creativity will enhance, though visuals, they will develop story building, translating visuals to language. I think that's an important. Sharing thoughts, laziness will disappear. Okay. LSRW skills. Enjoy.
Thank you, Abhishek. Yes.
Develop reading and writing skills. Healthy habit. Active participation.
Wonderful. I think this sort of...
Them to read the books shown in the game. Sujata, what was the software use for that random image picker?
It's called Random Picker. Random picker, and we loaded images from a game. Our children used to play these games in the library, so we moved some of them into this format, so we call them online and continue to play.
Yeah, because in online mode, I mean, how do you engage in library activities is another challenge. Although one loves the feel and smell of the books, but this time,
randomly we can stop.
Yes. Typically, if you're playing this in the real world, it's just a pack of cards. It's no pictures. We cut like cards and we shuffle it. And then children play. Actually, this is a game they've learned very quickly to play by themselves. Even large groups, we divide into small groups and they have such fun. There is a joker card also where you can change the order, you know, and there are some small things like that that help the game become exciting. So just to introduce you to something else that you could have done, we wanted.
I love the way because it is all about visual thing, visual and thinking. We normally we give words or speak a word, but now children are visualizing the words. It's a different thing.
It is. It's activating a different center of your brain, your visual center, that then has to go to your word center. The other thing is when we use pictures, it actually takes away the stress for a child who cannot read in that language, but who may have spoken language. So they can talk about something. Now, if everything is reading, that's where the library becomes a really heavy place for them. So lovely, thank you. The last game I wanted to play is really going to test your memory in the beginning. It's actually a very simple game called Bingo, which you would all know. What I'd like you to do is I hope each of you can find access to any sheet of paper around you. And I want you to just fold it to make three columns. So you'll have one, two, three, any bit of paper. It doesn't have to be so long. And it can be one-sided. It doesn't have to be fresh. But just fold so that you have three columns and mark the lines very clearly. I'll give you some time to do that. And when you've got the columns, also fold your paper this way so that you get three. Yeah? So it's going to look like this. Now we've got a rectangle and press mark it. And when you open it, I want somebody to tell me how many compartments do you have?
Nine.
Did anybody get 10? No magicians in this room. Excellent. So we've got 9 compartments. Now let's just keep that aside. Get your fast magic fingers to your typing board and put down words that we have muted. Put down words that we have discussed in the last half an hour. They could be from the titles of the story. They could be from the story you made. Just tell me some words. I want to see. Someone's put down the word synonym. Then there is the word. Oh, you're going very fast.
Do you want me to read?
Riddle.
I really want only 12. Wait, 12 words.
So only 12 words. Okay.
Synonym. Love, hate, elves. Child.
Cool. Random picker.
Random. Let's take random.
Samir. Silent. Stolen. Opposite. Footpath, illustrated.
I think we have to stop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Head curry. Pictures.
Okay, we'll stop. We've got enough.
Fine.
Okay, so I'm just going to type all these words in the chat now. And this is what we call our corpus of words. There are 12 words we're playing this game with, okay? So there is synonym, there is love, there is hate, elves, there is giant, there is random, there is silent, there is Samir, there is stolen, there is footpath, there is illustrated, and there is head curry. These are our 12 words. I want you to look at that list and pick any 9 words. In each box, please write down 1 word. So each of you will pick 9 words from the list 12. And in each box, you can write down your word. So again, I'll just give you a couple of minutes, 2 minutes maybe, to do that. Asavari, my camera is on, but maybe...
No, camera is on. We can see you. Probably she would be having an internet issue.
But I'm here, Asavari. I'm not gone away. So your words are random, silent, Samir, stolen, footpath, illustrated. I seem to have lost some. Synonym, love, hate, elves, giant, random, silent, Samir, stolen, footpath, illustrated, and head curry. You can't have any other words, okay? Then you'll get disqualified from the game. I like these reactions. Do you all have reactions? If you're done, just use them to tell me I can move on. Even if half of you are done, we'll move on.
Can you repeat the words?
Yes. Synonym, love, hate, elves, giant, random, silent, Samir, stolen, footpath, illustrated, and head curry.
We have got around 16 reactions till now, 18.
Out of 190.
Yeah. People are still joining and dropping, actually. So it keeps varying. Good that we have such interest in this kind of topic.
Such a lovely number. My God, I don't think I've ever done anything with over 100 people. It's so honor, such an honor. Thank you.
No, it's really nice. And I don't even feel that we are in the digital mode and we are quiet. I think people are interacting very well. So it's a really nice experience, I would say.
So we're ready, teachers. You all have your 9 words. Okay. Now, this is how bingo is played. Typically, you'd have this list on the board or on a whiteboard, and then children will pick. And the list is always and should always be visible to the children, because they need to know what you're doing with these words. It becomes a really powerful literacy skill for them to see that word and the word on the board. Because as you call out a word, you're going to scratch it out. Do you know bingo, like housey, loto? It's the same logic. When a number is called, we cancel it. Now, when a word is called, you'll cancel it. The first person to get a line can shout line, and Ruchi will give you a clap reaction. And then we'll play for full house. That is all.
If we had a, if we had a cup reaction, I could have given that.
Yeah. We should write to Zoom and tell them reactions have to improve. So teachers, are we ready? Everyone, excellent.
Yes, ma'am.
Preeti Kiran is ready, and whoever I can see is saying they are ready. Anoop, are you ready, sir? Excellent. The first word, which is my favoritest word in the world, is love. Please cancel love.
Yes.
L-O-V-E. Yes. Great. Moving on. My other favorite word is silent.
It can be in the row or column, whatever, wherever it is, it has to be cut.
So we love is gone, silent is gone. Head curry. If you wrote head curry, cancel it. Anyone winning? Not yet. You got 3, Preeti Kiran. Amazing. I'll give you a clap on my window. I don't know how to send a clap to your window.
You got there is a celebration emotion. You can use that.
Oh, so nice.
And also a heart, maybe.
Okay, so now we are playing for full house, huh? Three is gone. Yeah. Elves. The fourth one is elves. The fifth word is footpath. The sixth word is synonym. No full house. Not yet. No, it's not nine. The eighth one is three, four. Seventh one is random. The eighth one is illustrated. And the ninth one is
giant. One line.
A line. So sweet. Great job, Asha.
Thank you, ma'am.
We are playing for full house now. And the ninth word is giant. Anyone winning? The tenth one is Samir. No.
Aligned.
Done. Somebody got it.
Bingo, Neha, Devaki.
Excellent. Yeah.
Devaki, read
Neha
out.
Neha, Devaki.
Let me check. Devaki, can you unmute and read out your words? Not possible. Neha, can you read out your words?
Sure, ma'am. Samir, head curry.
Yes.
Footpath. Yes. Random. Illustrated.
Yes.
Elf. Giant.
Yes.
Love and synonym.
Yes. Wonderful. So this is called the checking round. And in class, any two children can also check each other. They love being that judge. So you can appoint one person to check another person's words. But fantastic. Should we just play to see more winners?
Kanchan Madan has also achieved. Kanchan, do you want to unmute and check?
Kanchan? Prabjot Kaur had two rows and two columns. Ooh, one is left, that means.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Kanchan here.
Ha, read out your words, Kanchan.
Yes, ma'am. Love. Footpath.
Yes.
Elf.
Yes.
Samir.
Yes.
Illustrated.
Yes.
Synonym.
Yes.
Random.
Yes.
Silent.
Yes.
Giant.
Excellent, Kanchan. You're a winner. Fantastic.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Quickly, teachers, before we wrap, what do you think was purpose, objective of a game like this?
Learning new words.
Okay, so they weren't completely new, right? They were words we introduced. For
students aware with the titles also. They become to learn the titles also.
Okay, so instead of learn, I would say what we are doing is we are reinforcing, correct? We use these words and now we're bringing them back. And when you bring it back, even that old experience of 40 minutes back is coming back. And this is really how vocabulary becomes part of our vocabulary in action.
Vocabulary enhancement, ma'am.
They are able to recap the things, recall the things.
Okay, what else happened in this game?
Even vocabulary can be increased. They are aware with the new words.
Okay.
Sharp memory.
Okay, memory. We try to remember. What else we did?
Instant answering.
And we reinforced the spelling too, because, you know, when children were copying from the board and writing it down, so very subtly, you know, they were revisiting the spelling too. So they tend to become good spellers and there's no one who's correcting.
Thank you.
Listening and then associating.
Listening skills both.
Thank you, Mamta. Listening and responding, right? You have to listen to the word. You have to identify that word on your paper. You have to then scratch it out. So it is actually a couple of cognitive skills coming very fast together in that game moment. And for many children...
Eye-hand coordination.
Yes. Many children who can't recognize words, that's why I said keep it up on the board. they check, are they canceling the same one that you are canceling? So they're also doing a word recognition, and this is happening in a microsecond. But it's really what the reading brain needs, to be fired like that, to process everything quickly, because our brains function like that when we read. So it's a game. It seems really simple, but it's doing really powerful things. And everyone has fun, including the facilitator, because it's light. It's not something that you've got to do enormous preparation for. The words come from the children. The material is simple. And across so many groups we've played it, it's always one of those winning games. So I wanted to leave you with that magic of bingo and encourage you to use it in subject teaching whenever there's new vocabulary, even at home, and to have fun and to remember that libraries can be very positive spaces. And I hope if you come to Goa, you visit us. If there are any questions, any burning thoughts, I'm really happy to respond to. But otherwise...
And I'm very happy with this new world game because I can use for any subject. Any subject I can do it. So, yes. You know, in primary section, it's very difficult to make them learn. But it's not about learning. It's about the game. They are, you know, entangled with game. But in the better half, they are learning the words. And it's very good. Thank you, ma'am. I will use tomorrow only.
I'm so glad. Thank you. It's my pleasure.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, could you please share, you know, some ways in which we can make use of virtual libraries effectively, you know, since we are thoroughly online as on date. And what I see is, especially for the junior school, that's how, you know, it is for a couple of months. So, ma'am, how exactly, you know, can we use virtual libraries so that it is a meaningful, you know, way of life for them? Because our children have been reading at school, so they miss the dear period. We do make a lot of effort, you know, storytelling sessions. We do reading fests and the like. But we share the PDF of the books with them so that they have access, you know, to books at home. And especially in a community where reading is, you know, not a way of life. So our children come, you know, from homes where probably the only book that they've been introduced is the checkbook. So when they come to us, they probably, most of them have never had, you know, any experience of what a book is like.
Yes. Yeah, Shilpi, can I, I'm just putting my email address in the chat box. Will you please write to me and we'll get on a call to talk more about this. There are so many things we've done in the lockdown with and this pandemic with children and schools, not so much virtually in the sense that we do things virtually, but we also are sending book boxes into homes and parents are coming and picking up stuff. So I'd really like to share some of that with you. So will you email if you don't mind and we'll set up a call so that I meaningfully support you. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am. I will certainly get connected.
Please.
Sujata ma'am, it's Nalini this side. Mine is the same question, and Ruchi ma'am, I would really appreciate if I can get an answer through mail or through any ways.
Nalini, you just take down my email and I'll also put a note together and share with Ruchi so she can circulate if she has all your
So sweet of you. So sweet of you. Thank you so very much.
This is what we do.
And Sudhata, I mean, I think Bookworm is doing really good work, has been doing for years, and even during pandemic, and the ideas that you shared today with us, I'm sure they are going to be very, very useful for teachers, even in this pandemic mode when we are connecting digitally. And in face-to-face mode also. And this is something in which I think learning comes naturally and it's not forced, and students also enjoy learning. And I think that's the most important point that we want to convey with these kind of activities. It was really very interesting for all of us and very interactive session. I have posted posted a link of feedback form for all of you to fill it up. Please do fill it up. It's very important for us. Do share your ideas about what are the other kinds of sessions that you would like us to host. We will also post a recording of this session on YouTube and you can access it later. It will take 1 or 2 weeks for us to upload the recording. And I have also shared the link of the YouTube site. You can search for Center for Excellence in Teacher Education and you will be able to find the YouTube link there. So please do fill up the feedback form right now. We'll be holding on to you. And I must thank you, Sujata and Lalita, really such an interesting session. I thoroughly enjoyed it. And I'm sure all the participants here would have also enjoyed it. It was a record turnout. I must say this is the highest turnout we have ever had in the School Synergy Workshop series. And it is really nice to see this kind of enthusiasm amongst teachers. I hope they will continue to use this ideas in their classrooms and that will be really achieving the objectives of these School Synergy Workshop series.
Thank you. Ruchi, I'm using someone else's office, so I have to log out.
It's okay, you can log out. We'll just continue for some time so that people can fill up the form and post.
Sure, I'll send a note to you about
Circulate. Bye-bye. Yeah. Bye.
Thank you both of you, ma'am. Thank you so much. And we will feel the feedback.
Yeah, sure.